Now, in this video, we will going to discuss about the principle of working of central line. Now we are going for the next chapter in the same module. So here, this is the sketch which shows the working principle of a central line. Basically, this is the workpiece which we have shown with the stepper bar, and this is the headstock, this is the tailstock, which is the dead center, and the headstock, which is called as the life center, and it is also a support where the workpiece is held between the two supports. And as the workpiece rotates in anti-clockwise direction, so this is the direction of rotation of the workpiece, the tool is fed perpendicular to the axis of the workpiece. The tool is fed, this is the cutting tool, where the tool is fed perpendicular to the axis of the workpiece. So this is the direction of movement. And also the tool is fed parallel, as it moved parallel to the axis of the workpiece, then the cutting takes place. This is the working principle of the center lathe, wherein as the tool moves from here to here, because due to the rotation of the workpiece, and as the material is removed from the workpiece, because the tool is harder than the workpiece which you want to cut. Let us see the things here. The machine works on the principle that a cutting tool can remove material when it is moved against a rotating workpiece. That is what I told you already, that as the workpiece rotates in the direction shown and the tool moves, so the material will start removing from the workpiece. This is accomplished by rotating the workpiece between two rigid and strong supports while the cutting tool is fed against it. So that means these two are the rigid supports and rotating, and as the tool is fed against the workpiece, so naturally the material will start removing from the workpiece. The tool material should be harder than the workpiece material, and it should also be held securely and rigidly on the machine. So that means the tool has to be held rigidly on the tool support and moved as the workpiece being rotated. The workpiece is being rotated by the motor, and the tool is fed by using the hand movement. When the tool moves parallel to the axis of the rotation of the workpiece, a cylindrical surface is produced. So what does it mean? So as the tool moves parallel to the rotation of the workpiece, so this is the direction of movement what we are talking about. So this is the direction which is parallel to the axis of the job. So naturally we will be able to develop the cylindrical surface. This is what the cylindrical surface what we are talking about. And when the tool moves perpendicular to the axis of the workpiece, it produces a flat surface. So that means as the tool is fed perpendicular to the axis, so this is the flat surface what we are talking about. And then as the tool moves at an angle to the axis of the rotation of the workpiece, a tapered surface can be produced. So this sketch we can see from here, as the tool is fed angle to the axis of the rotation of the workpiece, we are going to get the tapered surface. So here the tool moves at an angle to the axis of the workpiece, so we will going to be able to get the tapered angle. And when the flat surface, when the tool moves perpendicular to the axis of the workpiece, we are going to get a flat surface. So this is the surface what we are talking about. and when the tool moves parallel to the axis of the workpiece, so this is the axis of the workpiece, and the tool, this is the direction of the tool movement. So since it is parallel, so we will going to get the cylindrical surface. This is how the this is the working principle of the central lathe. So in the next video, we will going to discuss about the parts of the lathe. Thank you.